quarter, at least on the growth side, the results have been pretty strong. While especially on the North American market, the growth has been quite spectacular in terms of the numbers that we have reported. So also on the Russia CIS. And this was expected because we did indicate previous session that on the back of new product launches, plus also general growth in these markets, that these markets would do well. The disappointment is obviously India, because it is less than expected in terms of what we wanted to grow. So that's somewhat lower. As far as the other segment which is concerned, which is mainly the pharmaceutical ingredients, API has grown quite well. It's come back on track. And CPS also has, I mean, they'll explain the reasons why, but if I combine both services as well as active ingredients, it's, I would say it's pretty much in line in terms of what we plan for the growth. So this is the results that we have reported. All of you have already seen that. Just to comment on a couple of points as far as the P&L is concerned, we're calling it adjusted PAT, especially on the profit line, because there are two issues here. One is the voluntary retirement scheme, which the company has made a provision for. That's roughly about $3 million. That's one of the adjustments. And the other one is to do with the interest on bonus debentures, because we had issued bonus debentures, and for the first year, the interest on that, that's also another $3 million. So these are the adjustments that we are talking about here. So after that, this is the profit that we have indicated. Also, on the tax rates, if you've also seen as part of the P&L, not on this slide, but if you have gone through the tax rates, because of the tax benefit for some unrealized profits on the stocks that we have shipped to the United States in anticipation of a launch, that's why the effective tax rate looks lower. But on an annualized basis, it will get adjusted later. These are the two comments on the profit part of it. Also, if you have seen the growth at, say, 18%, the SG&A line has actually gone up to about 23%. And there are, again, a couple of reasons for this. The manpower cost, because we also have this Gemstone acquisition, which is basically this acquisition of the GSK facility. So those overheads are already loaded on at this point of time, while the sales will have the rest of the year to really catch up. So that's one factor, manpower cost. The second is we have also planned investments on the OTC segment in Russia, which is also a planned thing, which I will explain when I cover Russia, what we're intending to do. So both put together, it's about 23% increase in the SG&A compared to sales growth of 18%. Also, the R&D, which also we indicated that it will be stepped up from this year onwards. So that is also at about $27 million for the first quarter. That's an increase of about 21%. Right? So sales growth 18%, SG&A increase 23%, R&D 21%. Talking about some of the key updates for the quarter, we have just announced launch of fondaparinux, which again is a result of a momentous effort which the company has put in, because it's a very technologically complex product. We've been at this, working at this for quite a few years, and finally we're able to launch it in the market once we received the approval. Right? So this is one big achievement that the company has done. Also, the commencement of sales at the Bristol facility, we have just launched four SKUs as part of this from this facility, which is mainly penicillin-based products. But in the third quarter of this financial year, that's when you will see more scale-up of the launches from this facility happening.